Hey, space friends. I know things have been a bit quiet around here lately, and that's because I've been heads down on a few really big projects over the last year. I'm really excited today to at least share one of those big projects with you all. I'm going back to Antarctica. I am so incredibly excited to be going back. You have no idea. And so I'm really excited to share that project with all of you and also share, again, this time I'll be doing postcards from Antarctica. So if you would like a postcard from Antarctica or to get updates from me from the field while I'm there, I'll have more information about that at the end of this video. You'll remember my original Antarctic expedition back in 2018. For those of you that don't remember, I spent 5 years applying to and trying to get a grant to go to Antarctica, and I finally got one through the National Science Foundation's Antarctic Artists and Writers Program. Back then, it was so much fun and it was an amazing expedition. I was there for 5 weeks filming the little creatures that live under the ice everywhere. And so thanks to National Science Foundation's support, along with National Geographic and all of you on Patreon, I was able to go to Antarctica for the first time and it was absolutely amazing. The result of that expedition was the launch of lifeundertheice.org. It's an amazing website that's a microscopic tour through all the little creatures that live in Antarctica that I was able to film with my microscopes. You can go on there and see tardigrades and nematodes and rotifers and all sorts of things. Despite launching it at the start of the pandemic, so many amazing things came out of that project. I learned about people buying their first microscopes as a result, or discovering their first tardigrades with their microscopes, schools having amazing lesson plans that were based on lifeundertheice.org, lots of amazing things. And most importantly, people learned that Antarctica is in fact an oasis of life, that it's not barren and lifeless, but actually full of all sorts of amazing creatures. This time I'm going back to Antarctica for 2 months on two new missions. The first mission is that I'm going to be an embedded researcher on the McMurdo Dry Valley's long-term ecological research project, specifically working with their soils team that looks at the soils in the dry valleys and all of the microscopic critters that live there. It's going to be a lot of fun and I'm really fascinated with the project. If you remember, the dry valleys are the largest area of Antarctica that are not fully covered with snow or ice. So you can actually see the soil and the land itself on the continent. The McMurdo Dry Valley's long-term ecological research project is really an amazing team. They measure and document all of the changes that are happening in this region for the last several decades. And they do amazing work and they're such a critical team to really bearing witness to the changes that happen in this special region of Antarctica from the past to the present and how climate change might affect our future. The second mission that I'm going to be on this expedition is I'm going to be filming a mini docu-series about the Antarctic dry valleys through different orders of magnitude, from satellite imagery down to the microscopic level. This is inspired by one of my favorites, the Eames's Powers of 10 video, which is shown in art schools and science classes alike. I'm really excited about this, and I'm equally excited to share that I've received support from National Geographic for this project. It'll be an entirely self-shot docu-series, which is a lot. It's kind of, you know, if you've seen Bo Burnham, imagine that just with fewer lights and in freezing cold temperatures. But it'll be a lot of fun and I've got at least a tiny team to help me along the way remotely. If you'd like to receive a postcard from Antarctica from me for a limited time starting today, I'm actually going to be offering postcards from Antarctica to $5 plus patrons. And so if you go and sign up, I will send you a postcard from Antarctica. All patrons at all levels will receive updates from me from the field while I'm in Antarctica for those 2 months. But if you're unable to join my Patreon, no worries. We'll also throw a link in the description for how you can get updates from my Antarctic expedition by signing up to my newsletter. Stay tuned here for more as I prepare to go back to Antarctica. And if you've got questions for me about what it's like in Antarctica or any other questions, go ahead and leave a comment. We'll do a future video where I answer questions about what it's like there and all of the other questions that you might have. I'm really excited and I'm so happy to finally share this big update with you all. It's going to be amazing and there's going to be so much that I have to show you this time around, even more than I did last time. I'm just really elated and honestly just honored to be able to go back to this really special place. So looking forward to giving you all more updates in the coming weeks and months, and I'll see you all next time.